सो जय हिंद टू ऑल ऑफ यू। तो आज इस लेक्चर में हम जानने की कोशिश करेंगे कि किस तरह से एक फ्लोट वैल्यू को सिस्टम में स्टोर किया जाता है। तो जैसा कि हमें आभास होना चाहिए और ज्ञान होना चाहिए कि जब हम कंप्यूटर की बात करते हैं तो कंप्यूटर में जब किसी एक इंटीजर नंबर को स्टोर किया जाता है तो इंटीजर हमेशा एक्चुअल जो वैल्यू होता है वही एज इट इज स्टोर हो जाता है। तो जैसे कि अगर हमने 34 लिखा तो जब ये 34 जब स्टोर होता है कंप्यूटर में तो इसकी हमेशा एक्चुअल वैल्यू एज इट इज स्टोर हो जाती है। लेकिन जब हम लिखते हैं 34.53 यानी दिस इज द फ्लोट वैल्यू, जब हम फ्लोट वैल्यू को सिस्टम में स्टोर कराने चलते हैं तो हमेशा इसकी एक अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यू स्टोर होती है। अप्रोक्सीमेट कहने का सेंस क्या है कि किसी सिस्टम में 34.53 स्टोर कराएंगे तो हो सकता है कि 34.53000 अप टू एंड सम डेसिमल प्लेसेस तक आपको दिखाई दे। मे बी पॉसिबल ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि 34.529999999 इस तरह से भी ये दिखाई दे सकता है क्योंकि दिस इज ऑल्सो दिस इज ऑल्सो 34.53। सो वी आर सेइंग हियर द अप्रोक्सीमेट वैल्यू ऑफ द फ्लोट इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी स्टोर्ड विद इन द सिस्टम। So for that, IEEE organization is there who describes some of the rules how the system will get stored the float value, and they basically define the document number 754, IEEE 754, and the document they define, and that is known as the IEEE 754 float value representation. And in this document, that is the IEEE 754, they basically say that three types of representation generally have to be followed by the computer organization or the organization which basically develop the systems in the world, such as IBM is there, Intel is there, lot of organizations are there who basically develop the system. IEEE organization made the rules. They said in general all the organization who are developing the system either have to follow the single precision representation, that is the 32-bit representation, or have to follow the double precision representation, that is the 64-bit representation, and or have to follow the extended precision representation, that is the 80-bit representation. So right now, whenever we talk about the modern computer, you see the lot of computers are going to be developed right now and present in the market is of 64-bit representation. Yeah, 64-bit computers are there. Even the computers are not only the 64-bit. Whatever the software we are designing in the world right now, they are of 64-bit right now. So if we talk before 10 years, we see the operating system was of 32-bit. Rest of the software which is running onto the operating system was of 32-bit. But right now, the maximum softwares present in the market is of 64-bit, as well the operating system present in the market is also of 64-bit. Even the extended precision specification is still in trial, and no system, or we can say the modern system whatever we are getting in the market is not right now present with the 80-bit representation. Some of the organizations such as Microsoft, IBM, etc. also using the higher bit representation system within the own organization for research point of view. But in the market, we know only the 64-bit representation, a 64-bit operating system, 64-bit computers are present there. Or we can say, whenever we use the word 32-bit, 64-bit, 80-bit, it means we basically using the registers of 32-bit, 64-bit or 80-bit register within the system for developing the computer organization. Now we want to take one of the example for the single precision specification, what you understand by the single precision specification. So number has been given, or we can say the IEEE said whenever we want to represent a number float value within the system, it is going to be represented within the system by using the sign bit is either 0 or 1, depends on what type of sign we are using. If the sign is
sign is positive, then we are using the 0 bit at here. And if the sign is negative, then we are taking the 1 bit at here. So we are seeing that sign bit value is either 0 or either 1 is presented here. Second, we have to represent the exponent of that number. And third, we have to represent the mantissa of that number. So IEEE 754 specification said, whenever we want to store the float value within the system, it can be represented within the system via using sign bit, exponent and mantissa.
So whenever we take any of the number, so number is there, 1.00101 multiplied by 2 to the power 5. So we are saying here, this portion after the decimal is basically known as the mantissa. This is the mantissa is there. This 5 is here, this is basically known as the exponent. So this is the exponent is there. And since this number is positive, so this is the sign bit is there. Now we are solving a problem by using the single precision representation. That is the 32-bit representation. So we will take here, whenever we talk about the single precision representation, we are saying that sign bit always take 1 bit of data. Sign bit is always of 1 bit. Whenever we talk about the exponent, exponent is always of 8 bit. And whenever we talk about the mantissa is always of 23 bit. So we have taken the number. The number is given here, that is number equals to plus 100101.00. So we are representing this number in the form of mantissa and exponent. So we are shifting this decimal point up to here. So we are writing here 1.00101.00 multiplied by 2 to the power 5 is there. So where 5 is what? So 5 is basically the exponent is there. And exponent equals to 5 we get. But we want to represent the exponent in the form of 8 bit. So the exponent can be represented in the form of 8 bit by adding the 127 in case of single precision representation. So the modified exponent will become 127 plus 5, that is the 132. So this is modified. We have to convert this modified exponent in the binary value, and we know very well that the 132 is always the 8 bit representation. So this 132 will come in the 8 bit format. So this is the 132. Then after that, we are saying here, what is the mantissa? Since the number is there, so this is the decimal portion is basically known as the mantissa. So we are representing the mantissa 00101.00... up to 23 bit we can take, or we can write the lot number of 0 whenever the 23 bit is going to be completed. Again, since the number is positive, so we are writing here the sign bit is there, that is 0 for positive number. So we have a requirement of the three component to represent any of the float value. We have a requirement of the sign bit, we have calculated, the sign bit is 0. We have a requirement of the exponent, we have calculated, the exponent is of 8 bit here. We have a requirement of the mantissa, so we have calculated the mantissa is of 23 bit here. So finally, we want to represent our number into the 32 bit representation or single precision format representation. So we are taking here the sign bit is there, that is the 0. This is the exponent is there, that is the 8 bit. So 132 has been converted into the form of the 8 bit. So this is the exponent here and this is the mantissa. So mantissa we have taken at this place. So finally, this is the single precision representation of the float value. So in this lecture, we understood that whenever we talk about the float value representation within the system, it is going to be represented by using the three different style: single precision representation, double precision representation, or 80-bit representation, means extended precision representation. And we have solved the example using the single precision representation. Next lecture, we will discuss about the double precision representation. Thank you.